Blackstone Publishing presents The Saga of the Volsungs with The Saga of Ragnar Lothbrok, translated with an introduction by Jackson Crawford. This book is read by Jackson Crawford.
To Joe and Candy Turner, The Highest Peaks in Wyoming. Introduction. In a nutshell. The ill-fated romances, tragic murders, and larger-than-life wars of the Volsung family are alluded to and celebrated in numerous poems, sagas, and works of art produced in Scandinavia in the Middle Ages. And the Saga of the Volsungs is the most cohesive form of their story that has survived to be read in the modern age. In it, we read of Sigurd the Dragon Slayer, Brynhild the Valkyrie, and the iron courage of the brothers Gunnar and Hogni, and their avenging sister, Gudrun. The Saga of the Volsungs was first written in Iceland around AD 1250 by an author who had a strong familiarity with the traditional Scandinavian legends about these heroes. But the earliest manuscript in which a copy of the saga survives was not written until circa AD 1400. In that manuscript, NKS 1824 B quarto, the Saga of the Volsungs is followed directly by a sequel, The Saga of Ragnar Lothbrok, which concerns a legendary Viking chieftain of Denmark. This saga was written by a different author than the Saga of the Volsungs, and perhaps up to 50 years later. But whoever copied these two sagas together in this manuscript must have felt that they jointly formed a cohesive epic of one heroic family. Cast of characters, family tree, and synopsis. Reading from the beginning of the Saga of the Volsungs to the end of the Saga of Ragnar Lothbrok, the two sagas tell the tale of seven generations of one family, beginning with Sigi and ending with the sons of Ragnar, although the earliest two generations are passed over quickly in the first two chapters of the Saga of the Volsungs. There are numerous named characters in each saga, and the relationships among them are sometimes complex. It is important to note that Volsung is both the name of a single individual, the son of Rerir and father of Sigmund and Signy, and of his family. Sigmund is thus considered a Volsung, in addition to being the son of the man named Volsung. Inherited last names were unknown in medieval Scandinavia, but in the case of royal and otherwise outstanding families, a designation such as the Volsungs both honors a glorified ancestor and serves as a cohesive way of designating the family as a whole. Old Norse names ending in ung are typically designations for families and not for individuals, so it is likely that the original name of the individual Volsung was Volsi, and that his name was extended later to match the name of the family name for him. Compare the name Gjukung for members of the family of King Gjuki. This is supported by the fact that his son Siamund is called a Walsing, which equals Old Norse Volsung and Beowulf, as well as simply son of Waus, an Old English cognate of Old Norse Volsi. The name Volsi occurs in one place in Old Norse literature, in a story about the Norwegian king Olav Tryggvason in the manuscript Flateyjarbok. There, the name is applied to a stallion's preserved phallus that is worshipped by a pagan family. Phallus, perhaps specifically stallion's phallus, may well be the name's original meaning. The same root is found in other words for cylindrical objects, and the name of Volsung and his family might then have evoked the virility of a stallion. What seem to be last names are in reality usually nicknames. For instance, while Ragnar Lothbrok is well known by that name, Lothbrok is not his last name but rather a nickname, literally Shaggy Pants or Shaggy Shaps. Patronyms, names ending in son, are also sometimes used, but they indicate that the person in question is in fact the son of the man named. So Sigmund Volsungsson is the son of Volsung, while Sigmund's own son, Sigurd, is Sigurd Sigmundsson. The Norse god Odin precipitates the action of the Saga of the Volsungs. Odin is a much more complex, anxious, and deadly personality than his portrayal in popular media would usually suggest. Odin's great purpose is his struggle to prevent or forestall his own death at Ragnarok, the foretold end of the world when the giants and monsters will kill the gods in a final battle. To this end, Odin sends his Valkyries, mortal women granted the ability of flight, to choose the best dead warriors from earthly battlefields and convey them to his hall, Valhalla, where the warriors fight one another all day and practice for Ragnarok. Only those who die in battle have the honor of entering Valhalla. Men who die by other means, and apparently all women, go to hell, a shadowy underworld.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.